I would very much like to make some sort of safeguard so mm-hmm. that nobody could get away with it. So that if I would get drunk on power sometime in the future, if I'm still there, which mm-hmm. it's not certain, would not go out of whack, that some people could say that the general public or the minority of parliaments could stop it. We should be able to trust the president to make sure that things don't go out of whack, but he's mm-hmm. become a very political figure and he's sort of the godfather of this government. And so we don't, there's nowhere where we can actually get the necessary tools to keep them in check. And I'm very much afraid of if people don't understand that we have to do something now. And if this government is not going to be dissolved, because, you know, they don't have any authority. Nope. They have so much the minority that trusts them is always getting smaller and smaller. And it's not because I'm not looking for elections so that the Pirate Party can get posts as ministers and something like that. That's why I came up with this idea that I was discussing earlier, where we would actually transfer more power to the people so that the parliamentarians and the governments in the future could be more honest. Mm-hmm. But these are dangerous times in Iceland, and I would really encourage all friends of Iceland that are worried about this situation to call the ministers.
Finally, you talked about the future. If you keep this momentum and if you were able to win elections, I mean, be the big winners, do you think the Pirate Party would be ready for government? I mean, it was said, for example, about the Left Greens. They were really good in opposition because they were good at being opposed to everything and didn't.
But they had two very excellent ministers. Uh-huh.
Then they got into the government, and it was very problematic. As you say, they had two very good ministers, but they talked about chasing cats. It was
The wild cats.
Yeah, the wild cats in the party. I mean, you are a very young party with very little background, so to say.
Mm-hmm.
So do you think that the Pirate Party would be able to be in a government and you could work with somebody?
Well, this is a very good question, and it really depends on who would be elected inside. Mm-hmm. But mostly it would depend on how we would prepare for that sort of responsibility. I think, for example, the biggest problem that I'm seeing with the current government, mm-hmm. who is all, like, nobody has any experience of being ministers.
Exactly, none of them.
And they're not doing a very good job. So maybe they could have done something that I would encourage pirates mm-hmm. to do, is to hire assistants that are... understand how the system works, mm-hmm. and not necessarily yes people, but people that have understanding of how the bureaucratic body is, you know, so that it looks like the fate of many of the ministers now are the yes ministers scenario. Most people have seen yes minister.
Yeah.
That is why I came up with this idea that, mm-hmm. you know, instead of trying to go directly into governing positions, is to actually make that fundamental system change we need, and to and then, you know, after that, if that is successful, if we get a new constitution, then the rule of the game have completely changed. And I think it is very important to start to think about what is it that we want from a prime minister, and why is it that all the ministries are like little kingdoms that are fighting against each other? Mm-hmm. We have a very tiny system, and it should be much more transparent. There should be much more collaborations between people. And one of the things that I dream of, and I know I'm a dreamer, is to see people, you know, from all parties to work on certain things together openly. So it's... I, for one, am sick
sounds
of...
Sounds kind of naive.
Yeah, it is naive, but I...
But it's beautiful.
I've seen it happen uh-huh. Behind locked doors, you uh-huh. know, in the committee work.
Okay.
We want all the committees to be open, mm. and in Iceland, and it's very crazy. That's one of the things that I've just not been able to understand. So there's a committee work with usually 9 parliamentarians, and we get guests, and they have very good information that really should be shared. So the secretary of the committee, she keeps notes, or he, and the parliamentarians can't get the notes because it's for their work. Mm-hmm. And so nobody's keeping notes for us. And if we are constantly making notes, then we're not hearing the guests. And we can't have it open or mm-hmm. public. And so that is one of the things that we could fix immediately. And maybe we would be more useful in the parliament. And maybe not. It's just something that we... It's like, you know, I had personally promised myself to not carry on in politics. Mm-hmm. I was counting the days until I could move to San Francisco to after I'm finished with this term and just start to work on all the other things that I feel that I could be useful in. And so would the fate be then, like, let's say that we would get like 10 parliamentarians mm-hmm. and something, and then there would be only one experienced parliamentarian, that might be problematic. Yeah. And so I have to also, just as I'm going, to make assessments on how things will be. I have no idea. So it's like, and the same with the governmental stuff. I mean, it's like, that is not our main objective. Our main objective is to make the government and the parliament more transparent, more accountability, and more accessibility for people that should want to be more engaged. Because let's remember that we are the system. The system is not a separate entity. Mm-hmm. We are the system, and the system is only as good as how much effort we put into making it good. And nobody is going to make your dream come true about your dream society if you don't participate in creating it. And so I want people to be more engaged. It should be interesting and fun to have an impact and know about what we are doing in the parliament. My biggest disappointment was that nobody knows what we're doing.
Great closing words from Birgitta Jónsdóttir, the pirate captain, and perhaps Iceland's next prime minister. Who knows?
Oh, no.
We'll see. Birgitta, thank you so much for coming in here today.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. Þessi vest lærin í tvingabúðin er kjósumann. Ekk fólki típan er variant kjósumann. Misti enga mun í þessum svokallaða hruni kjósumann. Hann úr gulli þessi kálfur og þessi skítur ekki fara að móka sig sjálfur. Gullslegin kálfur og þessi skítur ekki fara að móka sig sjálfur.